can't say that I've had a consistently enjoyable time with Jedi Star Wars Fallen Order. I can say that I've had quite a bit of fun playing the game, and it's also a startling example of what can happen when Electronic Arts just allows a studio to make a game. This is just a video game that seeks to amuse its audience. It rewards the people who play it. You are constantly unlocking cosmetic rewards, even. You are attaining new skills at a consistent clip throughout the experience. It's just a video game. None of this loot box crap, not overly monetized garbo. This almost seems like a very deliberate, and it most likely is, a deliberate response to the controversy surrounding Star Wars Battlefront 2. This is almost a case of Electronic Arts saying, just this once, we'll give them what they want if they shut up about loot boxes. And if this is what we get when Electronic Arts wants to shut us all up, then Electronic Arts could stand to shut us all up a little bit longer. Keep doing it. If I shut up, EA, can I get more games like this? Because even though, as I said, I didn't have consistent fun throughout this game, it's got some issues that annoyed me a fair bit, it's still an honest-to-goodness video game with a baseline of quality and a sense of reward and progression for the player. The kind of game that Electronic Arts has been thoroughly disinterested in this entire generation. And I'm on board for that. So anyway, this is Jedi Fallen Order. It's fine. After I've just given you all that preamble, it's mostly fine. Basically, they've tried to do Star Wars with a bit of Dark Souls tacked on. It's got a very similar death and respawn system to Dark Souls. If you die, you lose all of your experience, all of your XP gets attached to the enemy that killed you, and you've got to get back to that enemy, and you don't have to kill it, you've just got to damage it. If you can deal some damage to that enemy, you get your experience back. If you rest at a save point, a meditation spot, then you get all your health and your healing items back, but enemies respawn. If you've played any Souls-like game, you know the deal by now. Combat for me was a game of two halves. For the most part, when I was fighting stormtroopers, I was really enjoying it. Fighting the stormtroopers is fun. You get to deflect their blaster shots back at them by blocking at the right time. You can counter and parry and do all kinds of cool lightsaber tricks when you fight the regular troopers. They'll come at you with those riot batons. And you can use your force powers. You can blast them away. You can pull them towards you. You can slow them down. And you can spend skill points to upgrade those. So instead of just yanking an enemy towards you, you can grab them and hold them in place in front of you like a proper old Jedi. It's so fun to yank. So fun. It feels good to yank. I really like the sense of personality that these stormtroopers have. They respond to you while you're playing. Some of them will call you out if you're dodging their attacks too much, especially the Inquisitor-style stormtroopers. Once you've whittled them down to one lone soldier, he'll start responding to that, either panicking or trying to convince himself, trying to psych himself up that he can do this, that he can actually take you down, and then you kill him because of course. So fighting stormtroopers is a lot of fun. Fighting the shitty little space animals, not so much. Some of the rubbish space animals, like the space rats and the space deer or rams or whatever, they're just space animals. They flail about wildly and they're really difficult to get a read on sometimes. And there tends to be a lot of them in one place. So dodging and parrying is more irritating. I just don't like fighting them. Stormtroopers, I like to fight. The space rats and the space insects and all that stuff, they can sod off. You can get certain upgrades, certainly some lightsaber upgrades that can help you deal with crowds more. But every now and then you stumble upon basically a makeup, a combination of enemies. And I've talked about this in various games before, where individual enemies aren't so difficult, but various combinations of them can really ruin your day. And there are certain encounters here, even with stormtroopers, where you're dealing with shitty little space animals and regular stormtroopers and ranged stormtroopers who are shooting at you, while flame troopers are also spurting gouts of fire at you. And sometimes, just sometimes, when the game tries to overwhelm you, sometimes the game feels like bullshit. And one of the big issues for me is I'm playing it and the game wants me to be careful, methodical, dodge, parry, duck, weave. It tries to instill something of that Dark Souls attitude in you, even though it doesn't control exactly like Dark Souls, but it wants you to be a bit more careful and methodical. When really, some of these big-scale combat encounters with a large variety of enemies, I feel like the game would have been more enjoyable if they'd spent a little less time, the developers, if they'd spent a little less time copying Dark Souls and a little more time copying Devil May Cry. I want to feel like my character is faster, more fluid, able to close the distance between himself and enemies way more efficiently. Instead, he moves more stodgily and just doesn't feel quite up to the task of handling all of the different enemies and attack types at once. And subsequently, I spent most of my time really wishing that this game was just, well, basically exactly like Devil May Cry, because a Devil May Cry combat system would just work so much better for a Jedi. But that's enough criticizing the game for what it's not. Let's criticize it for what it is. And it is mostly fun. It is mostly enjoyable. I will say, just while we're still criticizing, while we're still being negative, the platforming is largely wretched. In between combat encounters, there's some Uncharted style, Prince of Persia style, climbing up walls and swinging from ropes and all of that crap. And it's quite bad. Oftentimes, you'll swear that you're grabbing a ledge, and the character just won't. He'll just slip off and fall. And even worse, if you're sliding down a slope, there are quite a few slopes and ravines and stuff where you've got to skid down it, and you can't turn the character for shit. Cal cannot turn when sliding, and some of them require pretty strict turns, and I've had him fly off the side several times, or at the very least, I've got to try and jump my way down to course correct, and it just feels really bad. Like, I've played plenty of games that do that whole gimmick of sliding down a long slope, and many of them feel like some of those are really cool moments in the game. Here, they're awkward, and that's the best way to describe a lot of the platforming here, all of the wall running and rope swinging and climbing. It feels really awkward and somewhat archaic. There are many types of games, like the previously mentioned Uncharted, like the recent Tomb Raider games, where I can trust that the player character has got this. If I see a jump, I can trust that the character is going to make that jump if I attempt to make it. I can trust that the character will grab a ledge on a wall. Here, I don't trust the character. I do not trust that Cal has got his shit together. And that's not helped by the fact that the game is fairly glitchy. You'll notice in this video, footage that I've used of a frog that just stayed there. That was one of the minor glitches. Stormtroopers not quite knowing what the hell they're doing. I've simply transported through walls before. I mean, I talk about not being able to trust the platforming. Sometimes I'll just go through solid objects that I'm meant to be climbing and then die. I've encountered nothing game-breaking. Even if you fall to your death in this game, you respawn at the last time you are on solid ground. You don't have to go all the way back to a spawn point like you do if an enemy kills you. Though you do lose a bit of health. It's mostly annoying. Just little minor annoyances in terms of glitches, and a fair few visual glitches as well. Nothing major, just stuff like some textures not appearing, or bits of the scenery like not rendering at all, characters popping up in cutscenes. Some character will just suddenly appear after the rest of the scene has appeared for like a second. Nothing major, but they are there. This is somewhat sloppy in the technical department. So this is a game I've had quite a bit of fun with, albeit with a fair few caveats, quite a few issues holding it back, notable ones. I do want to talk about the game's difficulty. They do some interesting stuff there. There are multiple difficulty levels, and the different levels adjust the enemy aggression, the window of time you have to parry, and of course the damage being dealt. There's a super easy mode if you just want the story and want to feel like a badass cool old Jedi. There's obviously a super difficult one, and there's what I'm going to call two normal difficulties. Largely the same experience, but one is just a little bit more challenging than the other. I went for the more challenging one at first. A few people I spoke to said that they did that as well, and then bumped it back down to the lesser difficulty level. And about halfway through my experience, I bumped it down as well, and I did enjoy it more on the lesser one, which is the default one. Normally I just go default all the way, but I cranked it up a little bit when I first started playing, just because, you know, people kept saying Dark Souls, Dark Souls, Dark Souls, so I'm like, well, that's probably more in the spirit of the game to crank that up a notch. And then I cranked it back down a notch and had more fun. But that's just me. I do like that they've got some flexibility in their difficulty modes. I'm always a fan of that. And having four difficulty modes gives pretty much everyone an opportunity to enjoy the game at whatever level they want. So thumbs up. By the way, in this game's story, some wise Jedi master made a list of Force-sensitive kids at a time when the Empire is trying to kill anything related to the Jedi. So I spent most of the time thinking, God, the Jedi are fucking idiots. Anyway, the story itself is fairly mundane. It's not got a lot going for it. There are some really good performances, especially the chief antagonist, the second sister. She's quite cool, very, like, hamming it up, some classic Dark Lord stuff. And Cameron Monaghan plays the protagonist, Cal, and I'm always happy to see Cameron Monaghan. I'm a big fan of Gotham, and he did a tremendous job there. He does fine here. Sometimes he's a little bit flat, but for the most part, he's good. Overall, though, it's not exactly a gripping story. It checks the usual Star Wars boxes, but it is at least slightly more interesting than the bloody Mandalorian. So that's your Jedi Fallen Order anyway. It's pretty good. Got a lot of flaws, but it is pretty good. And there are a huge amount of unlockable cosmetics, which are fun to unlock, because when games are rewarding, they feel rewarding, EA.